Today, we'll be exploring 10 surprising facts about belly dancing. Welcome back to FTD Facts. I'm Sarah Carvalho, and I'm excited to get into today's video with you. If we look into the history of belly dancing, we will see that it crosses many cultural boundaries. Now, we like to show appreciation for all cultures and cultural practices, so why not showcase a long-adored style of dance that has variations in many cultures around the world? Interestingly, this unique style of dance started in the Middle East and Africa, made its way across the globe, and was later carried over into Western cultures as both a form of cultural dance and exotic entertainment. Today, the genre has gained considerable popularity all around the world. So, without further delay, let's get right into today's video on 10 surprising facts about belly dancing. So, let's start with the history of its name. The term belly dance is a westernized name that originally referred to traditional Middle Eastern dancing. The earliest forms of belly dance were the Egyptian Rawazi dance during the 19th century and Raks Sharki, an Arabic dance of the 20th century. Despite Egypt's location in Africa and contributions from other nations such as France, Turkey, and the United States, the term belly dance is usually used today to include all traditional dances of the Middle Eastern region, including those not geographically situated there. Now, let's learn a little bit about its origins in Egypt. So it is said that the first belly dancers were a group of traveling dancers known as the Rawazi. These women were considered gypsies in Egypt in the 18th century and were banished from Cairo during the 1830s, but went on to perform in Upper Egypt and later in the Middle East and Europe. Belly dancing was, during this time period, often known as Oriental dancing, and the women were made famous in Europe by authors and painters who were intrigued by the exotic nature of the art. Interestingly, it is also believed that belly dancing may have originated as a fertility ritual. 17,000-year-old rock engravings found in the caves of Adaura near Palermo in Sicily depict what appears to be a ritual fertility dance, as do ancient Egyptian tomb paintings and Greek sculptures. Moving on to the Raks Sharki genre of belly dancing. From the Rawazi troupe, the Raks Sharki genre of belly dancing began to develop. Now, in traditional Muslim society, women often gather to perform a type of belly dance after the evening meal, a dance they called Raks Sharki. After feeding their husbands and sons, the women would convene in a separate location to dance, as such activity was not permitted in the company of men. This traditional after-dinner dance was important because it enabled mothers of eligible bachelors to meet the young women in the community. It also developed the muscles needed for childbirth. As such, young women displayed their readiness for marriage by dancing for mothers. Let's move on and look at how this dance became westernized. Now, 18th century French explorers traveling in Egypt witnessed performers of a curious dance, which these Frenchmen termed danse du ventre, which means dance of the stomach. The French painter Delacroix, on a visit to North America in 1832, made this observation about the dancer. He said, "They are closer to nature in a thousand ways. Their dress, the form of their shoes, and so beauty has a share in everything they make. As for us, in our corsets, our tight shoes, our ridiculous pinching clothes, we are pitiful." He clearly had a bone to pick with traditional French fashion. In the 1960s and 1970s, belly dancing gained popularity in the United States during a time when more women were becoming free spirits. By this time, the dance had quite a sensual reputation, and Western women worked hard to reinvent it as a woman-focused dance that was performed in conjunction with female celebrations such as childbirth and New Age goddess worship. Quite interesting. Now, as with everything, there are misconceptions about belly dancing. So, the belly dance is not actually a dance of seduction, nor did it begin that way. Throughout Middle Eastern history, Oriental dance, which we now know is the proper term for belly dance, has been a family dance done at such occasions as weddings, births, and festivals. Men, women, and children in those cultures have always belly danced for fun, not to entertain or to arouse an audience. Moving on to fact number 5, the major use of muscular movement. Now, while belly dancing is very showy in style and costuming, the basic dance requires the disciplined skill of muscle isolations. For this reason, those with experience dancing jazz or ballet will do well with basic belly dance technique. The core muscles of the dancer's body execute each movement, as opposed to the use of external muscles alone. The majority of movements come from the hip and pelvic region. However, isolations of the shoulders and chest are also vital to a fluid-looking performance. And now let's talk about choreography. There are many steps found in the various styles of belly dancing performed all over the world. But the classic steps that come back throughout several periods in the history of belly dancing are the following. First, the shimmy. This involves vibrating the hips using the muscles of the lower back. You may shimmy front to back or side to side to create this vibration, and occasionally it is also performed in the shoulders. Our second popular movement is called undulations. These are flowing fluid movements throughout the body, including a pulsating rhythm of the chest and a circular twist of the hips and stomach region. And thirdly, we have hip hits. Now, these are sharp and quick pulsations of the hips moving out from the body. When performed up to speed, it looks as if the pelvis is swinging. But what you will be shocked to know, and what I was shocked to know, is that it is actually the weight of the legs pulsing quickly in alternation that creates the illusion that the hips are moving. Okay, moving on to costumes. Early belly dancing costuming consisted of a fitted bra top, a belt that rides low on the hips, and then a long skirt or flowing pants. These are usually covered in embellishments of fringe, coins, jewels, or sequins. This historical look was first portrayed in the earliest of belly dancers and is commonly still used today. Now, if you've ever watched a belly dancing routine, you will notice that there are tons of props. Belly dancing history also showcases a wide array of props that are used all over the world. American belly dancers very often use these as it increases the entertainment value of their performances. Now, more traditional belly dance studios may discourage the use of props, instead hoping to focus more on the physical discipline and artistry of the dance itself. Some props you may see being used at entertainment-based establishments, such as American restaurants, include fans, finger cymbals, tambourines, swords, snakes, canes, candelabras worn on the head, and veils or light scarves. These are, of course, all optional and are really left to the discretion of the choreographer and the dancer. And this brings us to belly dancing around the globe. In many parts of the world, travelers and locals alike fully expect to see a belly dance. You won't experience typical Moroccan nightlife without participating in one. Similarly, it's nearly impossible to visit Hawaii and not see their native belly dance, the hula. Recently, belly dancing has also swept the exercise industry. The dance strengthens the abdominals, thighs, calves, arms, back, buttocks, and hips. Participants can even correct poor posture with the dance's unique isolated movements. And because people usually find it more interesting than most other forms of exercise, it's become an enjoyable and sustainable way to lose weight and tone muscles for those of nearly any age group or fitness level. Now, not surprisingly, belly dancing can even be used during pregnancy, especially through the third trimester, to ready the stomach muscles for childbirth. All right, friends, well, this brings us to the end of our 10 surprising facts on belly dancing. Now, are you suddenly tempted to look into some belly dancing fitness classes of your own? I mean, why not try something new and fun, right? Wouldn't hurt. I'd like to thank you for tuning in with us today. We hope you enjoyed this video as much as we did. Now, tell us, have you ever tried belly dancing? And if so, what would you say is the most difficult part of learning this art form? Now, don't forget to leave your comments below. We love hearing from you. All right, that's all for now, friends, but don't forget to like, subscribe, and check out some similar videos in the description section. And of course, check back soon for daily videos. Bye.